In regards to capacity building, we are now suggesting this important degree, which is called MSc in NCDs. It has been officially approved by the regulatory body, which is Pakistan Medical and Dental Council. We are expecting to start this degree soon in Pakistan. And what we plan is that these will be NCD managers. So they won't be doctors. They won't be the one doing primary or secondary care to diabetes. They would not be diabetes educators. They will be diabetes or NCD managers who will be coordinating for the national healthcare network. So they may be involved in pharma industry, they may be involved in NGOs, they may be involved in corporate sector, they may in fact be involved as policy makers, etc., etc. Management updates. Now I can see in the program that next three speakers are speaking on diabetes risk factors and diabetes management. So I have at least done the slides for management updates. I can only share two important aspects here. One is guidelines regarding blood glucose monitoring. If you go through the literature, you hardly find guidelines for blood glucose monitoring, especially in our parts of the world. And this is then a big limbo. What happens is each doctor gives his own advice to the patient. That, okay, you check two times a day or three times a day or four times a day, or your fasting is important or your random is important or bedtime is important. And majority of these consultations are on anecdotal basis, each one's experience being shared with his patient. So what we developed is a document which is for low cost, or like in Pakistan, non-affording people. This document is called Bright Document. This is for better recommendations for blood glucose monitoring given to the GPs, developing by the advisory board. And like this is the flow chart. If you can, I don't think you can go through it, but it's just like giving a flavor of, there are four tables, table one, table two, table three, and table four. Perhaps it will be clearer in the next slide. So it's low intensity, moderate intensity, more intensity, and very high intensity blood glucose monitoring. And it has given the indications down below. So whom to recommend for only two times a week, whom to recommend for 7 to 14 times a week, whom to recommend for 14 to 30 times a week, whom to recommend blood glucose monitoring for more than 30 times a week. And the indications are also given down below. This document is already published. And I'm pleased to say that in Pakistan, we are having many institutes, many centers, many diabetes clinics who are following these guidelines now. I understand that my group had given to Sanjay one copy at some stage, and he's also going through these guidelines. We await Sanjay Kalra's expert advice in this regard. As regards diabetes management guidelines, and I understand Professor Tinsulet was also very keen to know about this document, the first guidelines were developed by Professor Samashera and me, myself, and a few colleagues in 1999. So it needed a revision. The revision has been done this year. This is named Prompt, Pakistan's Recommendations for Optimal Management of Diabetes from Primary to Tertiary Care. Majority of the guidelines, when we go and see whether they are national or international, we find that they do not guide us how to have the transition from primary to tertiary care. What shall be done at the primary care level? What shall be done at secondary? What shall be done at tertiary? What shall be the referral policy? What shall be the minimal infrastructure at each level? These guidelines comprehensively cover all these aspects. So it was developed by the Prompt Core team with liaison with the Advisory Board for the Care of Diabetes, PEN Pakistan. These are the 10 chapters, the table of contents. This document has been sent for publication. Hopefully in a month or so we'll have our document published in an index journal. What then happened is that we had a MENA Regional Council meeting in August in Pakistan, and this document, this very document, was accepted that we shall now customize it for the MENA region to be accepted as guidelines for the whole MENA region.
CFM, caring for well-being.